Day 7 of Patriots training camp. I'm Sierra Goodwill here with Evan Lazar. You're back there. You had your eyes on the guys today again. And we talked about Justin Rohrwasser, how he didn't have the smoothest start to camp, and then how he was nowhere to be seen when the media was allowed in practice. And then Nick Folk suddenly arrives today on Monday at practice, a veteran kicker who was obviously with the team last season. What did you see out of the kickers today? And are you surprised by the move at all?
I'm not surprised by the move at all. Rohrwasser has been extremely shaky, and that's kind of putting it politely. Today, they both went 4 for 4 in live kicking drills, but you could definitely see the difference between the ball coming off of Rohrwasser's foot and the ball coming off of Nick Folk's foot. I think the key for kicking, listen, you're not going to make every kick, right? Nobody is 100% all the time. But the key for kicking is you want the swing and you want the ball to come off the foot the same way every single time. So at least when you miss, you know what you did wrong and you missed within the margins. I think the biggest problem with Rohrwasser is that the ball is just coming off his foot differently every single time he kicks the ball. Sometimes it's wide left, sometimes it's wide right, and he doesn't really seem to have the ability too much right now to figure out where he can land it right down the middle. So I think that that's the biggest difference watching these two guys kick one after the other, is that Folk has that consistency. You know where the ball is going every time he kicks it. That doesn't mean he's going to make every kick, but at least you have an idea that it's going to be within the margins. Whereas with Rohrwasser, there's too many shanks right now where the ball is just flying completely like a frisbee off of his foot, and that is a little bit alarming if you're a Patriots fan.
Well, another observation from day 7 was the pass rush in rookie Josh Uche. What impressed you about him today?
Well, I had some concerns about the front 7. I wrote about it in my big recap of the first week of practices that, you know, really this front 7 has a ton of turnover. There's a lot of new faces playing a lot of new spots, and we don't have the veteran playmakers on that side of the ball that the Patriots are used to having, especially last season. Dante Hightower, Kyle Van Noy, Jamie Collins, those guys are all gone. So I think what we needed to see was what we saw today, which was Winovich, Uche, Adam Butler, Dietrich Wise, all getting home and all getting to the quarterback. And Uche in particular has really kind of taken on a much larger role than I think anybody could have expected as a rookie, playing off the line in early downs, then playing on the line of scrimmage in passing situations. And he looks good doing it all. It's just all, you know, from a mental standpoint, understanding his keys, understanding his run reads. That's the next step for him. In terms of boom plays, splash plays, he definitely makes those. But in order to be a consistent playmaker down in and down out, he's got to be able to work on those mental side of things. But he's got a pretty good teacher in Gerard Mayo standing out there at practice right behind him after every single rep, saying, you know, you did this wrong, you did that wrong, or whatever the case may be. And I think that that's such an invaluable person to have in his corner, to have somebody like Mayo who's played that spot in the NFL before, now coaching him. It must make it a lot easier transition for a guy like Uche.
We heard from Uche on Monday, so for highlights from his first press conference officially as a Patriot, you can find that on our website at clnsmedia.com and, as always, on our YouTube channel at Patriots Press Pass.
Patriots Training Camp Central is brought to you by Manscaped. Get 20% off and free shipping with the code MAXWELL20 at manscaped.com. Take your grooming game to the next level.